Hello friends, welcome you in this video tutorial. In previous video tutorial we have discussed about the Hibernate batch processing and we had gone through the different concept and I had shown you the some code snippet how we should basically perform a Hibernate batch processing, right? So this is the code which I had shown you in the slide, right? So here what basically we are doing, we are trying to save 100,000, basically 1 lakh record into our database, and in this loop basically this loop will iterate 1 lakh time or 100,000 times, and when you persist all 1 lakh record into the database, then in all objects is going to save into your session cache. And suppose if I increase the size of this loop like 10 millions, right, then in that case 10 millions record you are going to save into the caches, and cache basically takes memory from the Java heap, and there is some limitation for Java heap memory, right? And if you are going beyond of that limit, then you might face out of memory exception. So this is called an NT pattern, right? We should not write our source code like this. So it's basically this kind of code, basically there is possibility for out of memory exception, right? So I'm not gonna execute a 1 lakh times, but to show this demo I'm going to reduce this loop size till 100, right? And if I run this application, then what will happen, basically 100 records will be saved into the cache. And once you come out from the loop and you commit the, you try to call the commit, when you call in commit method on transaction, then all 1000 record will be removed from the memory and that will be saved into the database. So the basically flushing will happen on commit. So once you issue the commits, then flush means whatever object have been saved into the memory, that will be sent to the database in one go, right? But there is chance for the out of memory exception, right? So here if I go to the database, so here we are using the database is called test, and in this test database there is no table as of now. If you look into the Hibernate CFD.xml file, I have used a database schema name is called test, and my database is running on this port 4406, right? And HBM2 DDL I have given as a create, so database table will be created from the scratch. So you can see the client program, what name I have given, NT pattern batch insert client test. So if I run this program, and let me show you one more thing guys, here primary key generation algorithm I have selected as a table, or you can select as a sequence. When you select primary key generation algorithm as identity, then Hibernate is not gonna support a Hibernate is not going to support a batch processing. So that's the thing documentation says. So if you are going to select auto, then Hibernate is not gonna support you for batch processing. If you specify the batch size in Hibernate CFG.xml, then that is not gonna support. But here batch operation, we haven't specified any size in the Hibernate CFG.xml, but we have handled this batch size manually in the source code itself. So, and that is the another program I'll show you, that is here. But let's talk about the first NT pattern, right? So here if I run this program, then this is going to create a database table for us, and that will insert our 100 records in one shot, right? So you'll see a lot of insert query on the console. If I go to the database, then you'll get the 100 records in this table, right? So there is 100 records. So you can see the primary key that end with 100. So that is starts from 1 until 100. And when you specify the primary key generation algorithm as a table, then Hibernate basically maintains a separate table for primary key generation. That's the meaning of primary key generation algorithm table. Now this is anti-pattern, right? Here if you increase the loop size like 10 million, then there is chance for the out of memory exception, because all objects are going to save into your session cache. And when you call the commit, then all 10 millions will be sent to the database in one go, right? And there is chance for out of memory. Now, what is the resolution for this? This is the resolution for this. So instead of sending all 100,000 or 1 lakh record in one go, what you will have to do in for loop, right? This for loop is iterating 1 lakh time, right? So here what you will have to check, I greater than 0 and I modulus division of byte size 25, right? Whenever you get the 0, that means when I becomes 25, 50, 75, 100, 125, right? When I becomes the multiple of 25, then this loop is, if condition is gonna true. And you'll go inside and you'll call the flush. What does flush? Flush basically flushes the object which saves into the database. Basically that object will be sent to the database. And clear will delete all the objects saved into your session cache. So in that way you are keeping the session cache low, you are completely away from the out of memory exception, right? So as per the documentation, Hibernate documentation, if you go to the Hibernate documentation, then Hibernate documentation has suggested to keep a bash size between 20 to 50. So that is the basically suggested size by the Hibernate documentation. So here if you go to the Hibernate bashing, then they have given few examples and they have also given some suggestion what would be the appropriate size we should set while using a Hibernate batch processing, right? So they have given somewhere, I think in beginning itself, initially you can see talked about these properties what we had seen in the previous slide. So this property you can see what's the meaning of, like order updates, order insert and all. And here you can see since version 5.2 Hibernate allows overriding the global JDBC batch size given by the this property. Basically you configure in Hibernate cfg.xml and that you can override by this. So if you are dealing with the entity manager JPA, then you have entity manager, else you can say session.set JDBC size. So this will be override what size you are specifying in the Hibernate cfg.xml, right? So at this time I'm not getting. And one of the important thing, Hibernate disable insert batching at the JDBC level transparently if you use identity identified generator. So they have given in the note itself, right? And here batch operation, they talked about the flush and clear, right? And see, Hibernate has also in this example also batch size is taken as 25, and that talks about the, anyway, I do not get where they have mentioned the size, what appropriate size for the batch operation, but I read somewhere on the documentation, that might be old documentation, guys. So now if I go to the here second client program, Hibernate batch insert client test, right? And here we have used our batch operation, right? So what I'll do, I'll drop these two tables and just check for simplicity, just check for this demo, this loop size I'm gonna reduce as 100. I'll keep as 100 instead of 1 lakh, and this size I'm going to specify as 5. And I have given some debug point over here, just I'm going to enable this debug point. And database is clean slate, there is no table as of now. I'll run in the debug mode, just I wanted to show you so how batching works in Hibernate. Now this loop is going to execute 100 times, right? and we have given the batch size as 5, right? If you look in the top, batch size I have given a specified type 5. Now let's press F6 for line by line execution. F6 and keep watching this value of I. So value of I is 4 as of now. Now it's 5, right? Now this will control will go to the if loop, right? And before that, let me show you the console. So I'm going to clear this console, and if I go to the database, then you'd see table is created, but you will not get any data till it. There is no data, right? Table is created because while creating the session factory itself, all DDL query have been triggered. Now if I press F6, now size of I is 5, so definitely greater than 0, and I modular division of batch size would be 0, right? Because batch size I have taken 5. Now if condition became true, so control went inside and I'm printing flush and clear session, and now I'm calling flush method and hold down. This line of code is executed, but this I haven't executed it. Now let's go to the database and refresh, and here you can see 5 record is inserted, right? But flush, what does flush is doing basically internally commit as well. So 5 records is coming into the database. Now still your 5 object is in cache, session cache, so that we can clear by calling the clear method. So if I call clear method, then that is cleared from the session cache. Now if you keep running, now let's say size of this is 9, now size of this is 10. Now control will go to here. Now this line of code is not executed. Now if I go to the database, still size would be 5, but if I execute this line of code flush, then let's press F6 and now go to the database. Now you'll get the 10 records, right? So here you can see 10 records. Now this 5 records again I need to delete from the cache. So this will keep continue. So let me disable this and press F8, and all data will be 100 records will be inserted into the database. So that's the way basically your Hibernate batch processing works. I hope you enjoyed learning this video. Guys, this code basically I'm going to check in on the GitHub, and GitHub location I will specify in the video description. If you really like this video, then please hit on the like button and please subscribe my YouTube channel. So thank you so much, and see you next video tutorial.